So you guys are having some knowledge on core Java concepts, right?
Yes,
So that
yes.
is actually basic for Android, that is enough for Android application development. So let's get started. What happens with the Android applications? What we can do with that? So we have some presentations. I'll give it to overview on that. Then only the introduction to the Android, and tomorrow onwards we can directly went to the topics wise and we can do live coding. Okay, so what is basically Android, what we can do with Android platform? So we can say Android is an ecosystem. It has some platform architecture. It is not only an operating system, it has some SDKs, APIs available, and there are a lot of Android versions released recently. And we have challenges of Android app development and app fundamental. We'll cover all these topics in this introduction to Android. Okay, let's go one by one. So what is basically Android ecosystem, right? So Android is built on it's a based operating system is Linux kernel. So even Java is also based on that, right? So is underlying architecture, is underlying operating system built on the Linux kernel. So you know, right? Windows is different, and Linux OS version is different. So Linux is based on the file system based, and it has a user interface for touch screens. So Android, we can say nowadays, is a mobile device, right? It has some operating system that is deployed in the Linux kernel, and it has the SDK available to develop the applications. That means we have a user interface for touch screens. And used nowadays, Android, you can see, right, 80% of the market covered by Android because of the cheapest prices. You can say Apple covers 10 to 15% only because of the budget prices, right? So except USA, other countries usually on Android smartphone only. So that means it covers over 80%. So Android application development is on everywhere, not only a specific country, not only a specific place. That's why it is more into market. So we have not only mobile devices, we have different types of Android operating devices will be available. That is watches, TVs, and cars. So Android can be deployed in watches, can be in TVs as well as cars. So when you are an Android developer, you are not only for mobile applications. You can do watch applications, TV applications, and car applications. All the development activity will be same for across these devices. You are not into only into mobile application developer. You can do anything when you learn Android SDK. So you can see a lot of applications are available in Google Play Store nowadays, right? So it's more than 2 million. It's a bit old document, but it has more than 2 million applications. We can see a lot of free applications there in the Google Play Store, and we can see some paid applications also there. So any developer can do their own applications, and they can upload there into the marketplace store, and they can get money earning. So not only for the paid apps, even for the free apps also, they can put some ads like Google AdSense, Google AdWords. They can get earning money, right? So this is where the advantages of Android application. And this is actually a highly customizable for devices and vendors, right? So this is actually an open source API, right? Android is an open source API. You can do anything, whatever you want in the way, not like other mobile OSs, like iOS, Apple, or other things. So Android is open source, so you can do anything, whatever you want. Even you can build your own mobile device as well. So that is flexibility in Android. Okay. And coming to Android user interaction, right? So you can see you are already using some of the mobile devices like iPhone or Apple, Android, right? So it has some tapping, pinching, swiping, touching. These are the touch gestures. This is all already there for even for any of the mobile device. And we have some keyboard, right? Virtual keyboard for characters, numbers, and emojis. When typing in the chat or WhatsApp, we can use these things. And it supports usually Bluetooth, USB controls, and peripherals, even NFC, right? So nowadays, we can transfer the data over from one device to another device through Bluetooth communication. You can connect to the pen drive through USB controls. And we can share the data even through NFC. You know, share it also there, right? So it's a Wi-Fi direct concept in Android. We can also implement that as well. So a lot of things are there with Android. And we can see Android and sensors. So, you know, we have Android, each and every manufacturer will have their own sensors in Android device. You can see the camera, front camera is there. After that, you can see some of the sensors available in the Android device. These are hardware sensors. So these can be detected while when you are, let's say, when you are doing some activities, it will be recorded like steps, how many steps you done today. So something like that. The sensors will work on that. So it has the capabilities of device contents rotate as needed and walking edges positions on the map. Titling states a virtual car and controls a physical toy, moving to fast, disable game interactions. These are all sensors. You can see when you are playing a game, right? You can rotate and you can move your device from left or right. So this is that is based on the sensor API in Android. So it has a lot of sensors available. And this is basic Android home screen. So you can see launcher icons and self-upgrading widgets, and you can see multiple pages. You can put one of them in a folder, organized folders, and there is a OK Google concept. You know, in the Apple, there is a Siri, something like it is in related to OK Google. When you say OK Google, it will help you out on the not only the from the mobile device, it will be over from the world. You can ask anything, it will respond based on that. So it is also part of the ecosystem. So it will respond for your actions. That is, we call it as ecosystem. And some of the Android examples you can see. This Pokemon Go is a good application earlier. And you can see Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp. These are all the applications. You can see how we can do it. Now, coming apart from the Android OS operating system, right? So Android is also have a SDK to implement the applications. Like what we have is development tools, like debugger, monitor, editors. These are all we can cover when we are developing an application in the Android studio. So just learn what are the things are there, then we can when we are implementing an application, we can see these things. So there are libraries available. These are the default libraries in Android, like maps and wearables. Maps are for location tracking and wearables for developing the watch applications in Android. And you can see virtual devices, like when you develop an application, if you want to test it out and you don't have any device to test it out, the Android device, you can still use emulator. You can create an emulator. You can just deploy, run it on there, and you can see your application, how it behaves. And whatever you want, anything on the development side, you can directly approach developers.android.com. It has all the things available. Okay. And sample codes. You can see GitHub is also there for some sample codes. And this is where earlier versions of Android uses Eclipse. So you know anyway, right? So Java, when we are using Java, you can see Eclipse. So earlier also for up to Marshmallow, Android supports Eclipse. After that, it is not supporting Eclipse. Now it is supporting only Android Studio. It's an intelligence IDE, and we have to use Android Studio only. So we can get directly started with Android Studio only. Well, no, don't bother about Eclipse. So we can develop, run, debug, monitor performance. Everything can be done through Android Studio. So it's your official studio. We can download the Android Studio from developers.android.com. So directly it will download. Earlier, what we can do is when we have Eclipse, right? So we have to first install the Java SDK. Java JDK, then only we can install the Android. So we have to set up these environmental variables in a Windows. So then only we can get run with the Android application. But nowadays, it's not needed for Android Studio. When you download Android Studio and install it, it will take in care of all the things, because now it is not using Java JDK. Now it is using Open JDK. So it doesn't require to explicitly setting up the Java JDK. So Android setup will take care of all the things, setting the environmental variables or everything. We can just download it and install it. We can directly do the application. So that is an advantage of using Android Studio. Earlier, it is a very headache. We have to set it up everything, and Eclipse is also very slow when we are developing an application. But Android Studio comes with a lightweight and it is very fast. And you know, when you develop an application, right, you have to definitely submit to the Play Store. I can show you guys a later point of time how we can submit an application into the Play Store. So this is actually a official thing. So when you are release your application to the market, you have to definitely upload into the Google Play Store. Even let's say in your company, if they wanted to release the application in in-house release, like they don't want to release in a Google Play Store, still you have a lot of tools available, like TestFire is one of the thing, and Java is one other thing. So you can upload your APK file there, and you can get a link over it, and you can invite the people to get the downloaded. Not from the Google Play Store, you can still have other things also available, but it is a official recommended one. We have to submit the application in Google Play Store. Okay, and it has even if you want to release for your testers only before going to the live, it has a lot of concepts, alpha test, beta test. Also, you can invite a specific users to test the application and report the issues. Once you resolve all the issues, then if you want to move to the live, then there is a concept in Google Play Store. Still, you can do it. Usually what we can do is we can send the application to our testers. Once they reported, we resolve all the issues, and once they signed up, then only we'll move to the Google Live, right? So no need of having other tools. So Google Play Store is having that capability to give alpha test and beta test to you, and providing the tester, they can do it directly. And now this is the fundamentals of what is about Android, and what are the things are there, and how we can do the application. So now, what is actually a Android platform architecture, right? So as we know, right, so this is built on some Linux kernel operating system. So it has some SDKs available, it has some APIs available. So how these are organized in a structured way, right? So these are should be communicated each other, then only we can get, let's say when you touch anything on the screen, it should be intimate to the operating system to respond back. So when you are touching an application, it is why it is opening, it should be communicated to the operating system to open the application. So how this communication is happening, and when we are pressing the camera, how it is opening and how it is taking the capture, all the things, we have to see the architecture platform. So you can see this is Android actually architecture. So what we said, right? So it's actually built on the Linux kernel operating system, and it has the hardware abstraction layer. So what is hardware abstraction layer, right? So you know, and Android operating have these capabilities, right? Hardware capabilities like sensors, camera feature, and a lot of other features are there, right? So how these are can be accessed to our applications through hardware abstraction layer. This is the layer actually communicating with the operating system. Whatever the touch event or whatever, when we want to access the camera, everything will be going through this hardware abstraction layer. This is the layer which will communicate with a Linux kernel and respond back to the applications. So we can see one by one each other, right? Okay. And we have system application. These are user applications, right? What is system applications? You can see when you have an Android mobile device, you can see a lot of default applications like contacts app, call app, messaging app, and camera app. These are all called system applications. That means the default applications in the Android mobile called as system applications. And user applications are what we are developing it on the Android device that we can call it as user applications. This means customized applications. And we have a Java API framework, right? Earlier we are using JDK, Java Oracle JDK. Now it is Open JDK platform. So it's a based on when the coding will be all similar to the Java only, but that communicates with Java API framework. And we have other supports with native C, C++ libraries. We can still coding with the C, C++ within it and native NDK. NDK SDK is there. So we can build that. This is mainly useful for some gaming purposes. So when we are developing in a game application, you must do actions on native C, C++ because when you write the code in for a gaming application in Java, it is very heavy on the OS. So C++ is for lightweight communication with the operating system. So that is why they approached with the C++. It will directly, it's a low level language, right? You can see low level language easily converts into the bytecode and it will be communicated with the Linux kernel. So that is the advantages of using C++. But that is why Android supports that. And we have Android runtime. So we have a Dalvik virtual machine. So when we are compiling and building it, and that will be converted to the bytecode and it will be communicated with the OS operating system. So even Java also having JVM, right? So similar way Android has their own runtime machine. Okay, and let's see one by one. So as I told you, system and user apps, right? So system apps have no special status. System apps have provide capabilities, developers. That is something like SMS message. So, and Java API framework. So the entire features set of Android OS is available to you through APIs. As I told you, it will be communicated through that. So view class hierarchy to create UI screen, notification manager, activity manager. These are all some of the features of Android API and content providers. We can see one by one, what is notification manager, what is activity, what is content provider. We can see everything. And then what is Android runtime? As I told you, right? So each app runs in own process and which has own instance of the Android runtime. So each application, you know, right? Each operating system has different processes available. Even now I'm running in the laptop, right? I can see a lot of processes and a lot of applications running in the system, in the RAM memory. And whenever you create an application and running it, it will be created with one process. So Android also having some capabilities. One application can be have multiple processes as well. So how we can create different processes in Android application, we can see later point of time how we can achieve it.